Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we are talking about social media for pet professionals. As you guys know, I was a dog walker in Toronto for 6 years, and now I'm doing a master's degree in digital marketing, and I'm specializing in social media marketing. When I was dog walking, I didn't use social media in terms of a business plan until the very end of it, and I noticed, honestly, a huge difference. So I just want to share with you guys some advice and some tips when it comes to social media and how you can use it for your business. This is going to be an introduction because, honestly, I could talk for days and days about social media, but that's for another video. If you guys have any more questions, then please let me know in the comment section. Social media is so important for pet care professionals because it builds a sense of trust between you and the client. These clients are trusting us with their babies. It's not like with children where when the child comes home, they can ask how their day was. These are animals that can't necessarily speak to their clients, and we need to show them that we are trustworthy individuals, and a really good way to do that is through social media. I am filming this video in 2020, so if you're watching this video years from now, just keep in mind that social media is changing all the time. So the things that I'm saying in this video might not necessarily be applying to you, but let's get into it anyway. There are a lot of social media platforms to choose from, but if you dip your toes into every single one of them, then you're gonna be spreading yourself thin and you're gonna be wasting all of your efforts. So the best thing to do is to choose the ones where your clients actually are. So in 2020, that is Facebook and it's Instagram. TikTok is wildly on the rise, but generally this is a younger demographic, which means that these people don't necessarily have any buying power. So it's best right now just to stick to Facebook and Instagram. As a pet professional, your goal is not to become as large as possible. It's not all about the followers. It's about gaining new clients and giving the clients that you do have a sense of happiness and trust in your services. If you're targeting people all across the country, these people aren't necessarily going to turn into clients because they don't live anywhere near you. So you want to kind of target it and hone in on a certain area where your clients are actually going to be. So use hashtags that reflect that. For example, using a hashtag like Dogs of Instagram, that is a big one. It's going to be put forward towards a lot of people, but the problem with that is most of these people won't actually turn into clients. But if you were to use, let's just say you live in Toronto, and if you were to use Dogs of Toronto as a hashtag, that's gonna be put towards people that are in Toronto that are more likely to become clients of yours. So it's better to stick with those types of hashtags. So let's start by talking about Facebook. So for this, you wanna create a professional page. Don't use your personal one. And you're gonna wanna post every single day. So whether that's original content, pictures, or even just sharing somebody else's post, you wanna do this every single day so that it's popping up on people's feeds. Make the captions that you write really quick and eye-catching. So every once in a while, you can write something that's a little bit longer, but in general, people don't stop to read that entire post. So mostly you wanna make them really quick and easy to read. You can put emojis in there. Just make it something that people will stop and read really quickly and then click on whatever it is that you're offering for them. Always encourage engagement. Engagement is the biggest thing. You want people to engage in your content, whether it's likes or comments or especially shares. Those are super important. So in your captions, ask questions, get people talking, kind of give people a starting point that they can engage with your content. Hashtags are less important on Facebook, but you still want to use them because that's how Facebook kind of categorizes the types of content. So I would say use about 3 or 4 in your posts. On Facebook, there are so many different neighborhood groups depending on where you live. And in these groups, people are constantly asking questions, looking for recommendations, posting photos. And this is prime opportunity for you guys because this is where you can find clients. Obviously, don't go into these groups and just spam it by offering your services. You can just simply post photos of the dogs that you're walking, having a good time. Things like that will get people to remember you, responding informatively to people's questions. Things like that will really get you seen. It will make people become aware of your Facebook page or your website or your services even. So it's really good to interact with those kinds of communities. Most communities will have Facebook pages like this. So just look for ones that are gonna be in your area. Facebook is notorious for having a small reach, which basically means that it doesn't push out your content to new people, but it only puts it on the newsfeed of people who are already following you. So a good way to get past this is to invest in Facebook advertising, because then it just gets out to more people. Of course, if that's not in your budget, then that's not really an opportunity for you. But if you do put that in your budget, then that is a really good way to be seen by new people. I can make a whole other video on that because that is quite in-depth, and for this video I think it would be too much to go into it, but it is a really good thing to look into if you're looking to expand your business. You can even make it location-based so that your advertisements are going out just to a certain location if you're looking just within your city. Okay, Instagram is another really good one. Instagram is owned by Facebook, so there are gonna be some similarities and some differences. In my opinion, Instagram is one of the best ways for you to connect with your current clients because you can post pictures and videos of their dogs having fun out on adventures, and that will then in turn stimulate new clients to come in because they're seeing what great services you're offering. Again, use a business account as opposed to a personal one unless your business is personal. So for example, if you're a dog sitter and you're kind of selling that whole dog sitter lifestyle, then you can do that. For me personally, I mesh the two together because for me, since I do social media here with these YouTube videos and things like that, for me it's a personality thing with the animals, so I mesh the two together. So just figure out what works best for you and your business, but for most pet professionals, two separate accounts will work best. On Instagram, you can post photos onto your feed, but then you can also post stories. So as you're going through your day, walking or grooming, whatever it is that your job is in the pet profession, take photos of it and then you can share it online. So when you have a lunch break, you can either share it then, or once you're done your full day, you can send all of those things out, and then clients are able to see what it is that their dog is getting up to in the day. With Instagram, you do want to post every single day, but you also don't want to spam your feed. So at most, you want to be posting 3 photos on your feed. That's the absolute maximum. There is no maximum in terms of stories. You can keep on uploading as long as you want, but 3 on the actual feed. Of course, you don't have to do 3. One is fine, but if you want to do more, then 3 is great. Hashtags are very, very important in Instagram because that's how it knows how to categorize all of your content. So again, using hashtags that are specific to your location and your industry, you can use the exact same ones for every single post. You can just copy and paste and put it into a note on your phone, and then you can just use the exact same ones. That's a really good idea. Saves a lot of time as well. Instagram will pick up on hashtags whether they are in the actual caption or if they're in the comment section. So you can kind of choose which one works for you and your aesthetic. I personally don't like putting too many of them in the caption, so I'll usually put 3 or 4 in the caption, and then I'll put a whole bunch of them in the comment section. So you can just choose what works best for you, but it will work either way depending on what you choose to do. Again, you want to respond to every single comment and try to work towards engagement. So ask questions. There's little stickers that you can put in your story that can kind of create engagement, little text boxes, things like that, that you can get people interacting with your content, and you definitely do want to do this. Engagement is so important. You can also run ads on Instagram. You can do this through your Facebook business page because Facebook and Instagram are together, so you can run your ads together. You can even run the exact same ads on both different platforms. Again, I'm not gonna get into too much of that in this video because that's a whole thing all on its own. It would take so long to talk about that and explain it, but if you have some questions, you can put it in the comment section. I can kind of steer you in the right direction with that. You may feel a little bit self-conscious about taking pictures of yourself, but I do find that having some pictures with you and the dogs makes a huge difference. Again, we're building a connection with the clients because the dogs are spending time with us all day, but the clients don't necessarily. So we want to build a kind of relationship with them as well. And we do that with photos. Also, for new clients, it helps them to get a sense of your personality. They don't necessarily know you, and having photos of you on there as well will help them to get a sense of who you are, and they might be more likely to hire you then. This may seem like it's a lot of work, and it is kind of a learning curve. It can take a little while to get into a routine with this, but I promise you it will pay off in the end. Not only will it help the clients that you have now to feel good in their choices to hire you, but it will help to bring in new clients because they'll be able to see how much fun everyone's dog is having, or cat, and they'll be more likely to hire you in the future. This is a huge topic that I could honestly talk for days about. If you guys want me to do another video breaking down any kind of aspect of this, I would be happy to. I love this stuff. As you guys know, I'm doing my master's degree in it, so I could talk about it forever. But for the sake of this video, for it being just an introduction, I'm gonna end it there. Thank you guys so much for tuning in and watching this video. I think it is such an important topic, and I'm so happy that I'm able to bring it to you guys. Make sure to subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in the next video.